And we here with Eric Kelly for EsNews. Yo, man, how do you feel about this whole PBC thing going on, man, and bringing it back to, you know.
Bringing it back to regular TV, Barclays Center, bringing it back to Brooklyn. I mean, that's the best thing in the world. I love PBC. Al Heyman is a genius. Al Heyman got the monopoly on the game right now. You know what I mean?
They took out Friday Night Fights.
Friday Night Fights, you know what I'm saying? PBC's on that. Al Heyman got the Spike deal. Al Heyman got the NBC deal. Like, if you want it, he got it. If he don't got it, he gonna get it. So what he said, get it while the getting's good.
Yo, if you had a chance to train one of these fighters who's currently not under anybody, who would you have an interest in that you see would go great with your style?
With my style, none of the motherfuckers. And I'm not lying, none of the motherfuckers. I don't want to train not one of these motherfuckers.
You're still training them yuppies in that gym?
Fuck the yuppies too. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, I be working with them, but fuck them too. Kid Chocolate, that's my man. I love Kid Chocolate. That's my little brother. Fuck Kid Chocolate. Andy Lee, Crunk Boxing Gym. You know, I used to train at the Crunk back in Detroit when I was there. Fuck Andy Lee. Danny Garcia, Philadelphia. I know all the guys from there. I love them. Fuck Danny Garcia. Lamont Peterson, my man from the Amateurs, his whole crew, the Headbangers, I love him. Fuck Lamont Peterson. The thing is this, I'm not a trainer. I'm the inner trainer. I train to talk shit. I love all these guys. I'm not a fucking trainer. You might see me holding the pads for the Wall Street guys and everything.
Yeah.
Don't bring no fighters to me. Let me tell you what fighters do. Guys bring a fighter up from the ground up, and I've seen this in the gym for my whole life. From the ground up. Once the fighter gets to that point where he's about to make money or start making money, he did it as his trainer. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Now he got somebody that the promotion company got with, you got to train with this guy. This guy's in the camp. So the trainer that nurtured you from the ground up has to take a back seat. Bullshit. I don't want nothing to do with it. You know what I mean? So, I mean, I love boxing, obviously. I love training the little geeks that I train down at Wall Street. Yeah. I'm talking to you, motherfucker. Anyway.
What's your prediction, Mayweather Pacquiao, man? Who you see realistically in that, man? Your honest prediction.
I'm a money team man. You know what I'm saying? I'm a money team man. But Pacquiao's gonna win. Let me tell you why. Vegas love Floyd. Hold. Vegas love Floyd. Floyd generates so much fucking money, it don't make no sense for Vegas. Vegas love Floyd. But one thing Vegas love more than Vegas love Floyd is what?
Money.
You're
going to want that rematch.
So you want that Pacquiao win the first fight? Then guess what's going to happen in the second fight? Floyd going to win that, and Floyd going to win the rubber match. You know what I mean? Look at it. I mean, use your head for more than a fucking hat. You know what I'm saying?
Evander Holyfield said the same thing.
I mean, it's business. It's business. It took 6 years for this first fight to fucking happen. Now you think you're getting two? Come on, B. If Mayweather win, he might not fight the motherfucker again. But if Pacquiao win, Mayweather won his comeback. You know what I'm saying? You motherfuckers about as smart as a box of rocks. You gotta use your head for more than a hat rack. Alright? This shit is real. Think.
Do you think, now I know you said Al Heyman's a genius, and I feel the same way with PBC, yeah. And this is like amazing. Do you think that a lot of this are build-up fights to build up his fighters? Or do you think these are really good fights? Because they seem good on paper.
Al Heyman got the monopoly on the game. He got over 100 fighters, you know what I'm saying? He got all these deals with all these networks. That's beautiful. He got the number one fight in the game. With that said, Lamar Peterson versus Danny Garcia.
What's your prediction?
Where's the wrong in it? I mean, it's had a catch weight, okay. No titles on the line. But guess what? They fighting. You know what I'm saying? When Lucas Matisse fought Danny Garcia back in 2013, you know what I'm saying? Adrian Bronner, Marcos Medina, everybody talk bullshit about what Al Heyman is doing. Let me tell you a little dumb mother. Who's doing better? Bob Arum fucking motherfuckers left and right.
Yup.
Motherfuckers going to meet with Bob Arum, they got the Vaseline with him. No disrespect to Top Rank, but I gotta call it how I see it. Contrary to popular belief, this IC pretty motherfucking good. I gotta call it how I see it. You know what I'm saying?
What's been your favorite fight thus far on PBC? Mine is Keith Thurman, Robert Guerrero.
Keith Thurman, Robert Guerrero was crazy.
But I like Chris Areola and the other guy. I forgot his name. Chris Areola in that fight was good too.
The Adrian Brown, yeah, too fat, motherfucker.
Yeah. That's the truth, but they were going at it though.
Not really. I ain't got time for that bullshit. I'm gonna have to go because we ain't had many yet. So I'm gonna have to go with Chris. I'm gonna have to go with
Keith Thurman.
Keith Thurman. I love one time. Robert Garcia is a bad motherfucker. I love one time. Everybody talking about one time and Floyd, stop that bullshit. It's fucking Floyd Mayweather.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? One time may beat Mayweather then.
Who do you think's the runner up then? Who gets a winner? Who's the second? Is it Keith Thurman, Amir Khan? Is it Demetrius Andre? Do you think he's in there, that mix?
I gotta throw Demetrius Andre in there. And around that weight class? Are we talking about
from 147 to 154.
All right. Wow.
Thurman, you got Canelo.
Let me tell you super motherfucker something. I think, if I'm not mistaken, Andre beat Thurman's ass.
He beat him three times.
Andre got that number two. Come on, Boo Boo. Gotta get better than the Boo Boo.
Andy a little bigger than
you. Andy a little bigger, sharper, longer boxer. You know what I'm saying? You gotta get that in the Boo Boo. And don't sleep with my little brother Saddam Ali right now in the welterweight division.
What did you think about that Charlo fight?
Listen, huh?
The Charlo fight.
Fuck Charlo.
Yeah, man, that was a boring fight, man.
Boring.
Fuck both of them with a sick dick.
Yeah.